In this video, we are going to learn the philosophical approach to study the political theory. As we've discussed earlier, political theory is studied under traditional approaches as well as the modern approaches. The traditional approaches comprises historical approach, philosophical approach, institutional approach, legal approach, and so on. So philosophical approach is one of the traditional approach to study political theory. Philosophical approach is the oldest approach, and it can be traced right from the times of Socrates, Plato, and it has continued even in the contemporary and present times. Philosophical approach is a very profound approach. It is so profound that it has evolved as a subject and a discipline in itself. Philosophical approach dwells upon the ideas like equality, liberty, what are the grounds of political obligation, rights, and so on. So there is hardly any idea that the philosophical approach has not touched upon. The philosophical approach deals with the normative aspects of the political theory. Like for example, it analyzes what is the ultimate goal of life, what is the ultimate goal of the political association, what should be the ideal state, what should be the values that should govern the society and the political system at large. So the philosophical approach is largely concerned with normative aspects. It is concerned with values. It is concerned with ideas. In this context, it is important to note that Plato is called as the father of the political philosophy. Now, philosophical approach is concerned with what ought to be. It is concerned with the ideas. It is concerned with the values. For example, Plato says that it is the reason which ought to rule the state. So you see, the philosophical approach is embedded in the Plato and his ideas. Now, philosophical approach is concerned with what ought to be. It is concerned with what values should govern the society, what values should be upheld in the political realm, and so on. For example, Plato says that reason ought to rule the state. So you see how the philosophical approach is strongly reflected in the ideas and works of Plato. Similarly, the philosophical approach is concerned with right and wrong. For example, Karl Marx says that communism is right and capitalism is wrong. Similarly, the feminists and especially the radical feminists say that the patriarchy or the institution of patriarchy is wrong and the idea of sexual equality is right. Similarly, the philosophical approach studies the ideas, it studies the value. Like for example, it studies justice, liberty, equality, ends, values, rights, and so on. Philosophical approach is concerned with analyzing a large array of ideas and values. The method to study the philosophical approach is largely logical. We must use a critical analysis, reasoning, and dialectics to pursue this approach. For example, Plato uses the idea of allegory of caves, which shows the philosophical approach and the method to pursue this approach. Plato says that when a person is standing at the mouth of the cave, he sees the reflection of his shadow on the wall of the cave. He thinks that the shadow is the reality. However, when the person turns back and looks at the light, he knows that the shadow was not real. So in this way, Plato says that the reality or the material world is not real, whereas the world of ideas is real. So you see how reasoning, logic, and dialectics is a part of pursuing the philosophical approach, which is also seen in Plato. Now, we have studied that the philosophical approach is a part of the traditional approach to study the political theory. This does not mean that the philosophical approach is irrelevant in the present times. Philosophical approach has inspired the post-behavioral approach. It has inspired feminism. It has inspired the critical school of thought and so on. Leo Strauss, who is a post-behavioral scholar, says that we should be equally concerned with the values and we should not reduce the political theory to mere political science. So you see, philosophical approach is relevant in the present times. Similarly, the feminism has come up with the ideas of patriarchy, sexual equality, and so on. This shows the concern for the values in the feminism as well. The philosophical approach sets the ends which the means are supposed to achieve. For example, Gandhi talks about the ends of Sarvodaya and he prescribes the means of the doctrine of trusteeship, Ramrajya and so on to achieve the end of Ramrajya. So the philosophical approach, we can say that it sets the ends which the means must achieve. In this context, it's important to note that king ought to be wise in the world of ideas, in the opinion of Plato. This shows the philosophical approach in the overall ideas and works of Plato. Now let us understand the significance of the philosophical approach. The philosophical approach brings in the linguistic clarity of concepts. Let me explain this thing with a small example. Take the example of the idea of liberty. Now traditionally, liberty or freedom was confined to mere legal freedom or political freedom. However, in the contemporary times, the scope of liberty has expanded and now we talk about the sexual liberty, we talk about the digital liberty, we talk about individual liberty and so on. So you see how the idea of liberty has been emerging and how it is evolving. It is the philosophical approach which helps us to understand these ideas with the evolving consciousness. Similarly, the philosophical approach also helps us to understand what values should be upheld in the political realm, what values should be upheld in the social realm, and so on. For example, Plato said that we should uphold the ideal of justice, and it is the justice which is the most important value that we should uphold. Similarly, the philosophical approach can be understood as a sort of a continuous dialogue among the values. We can say that a set of values called the thesis clash with the emerging ideas, which can be called as the antithesis, and through this synthesis, new ideas keep on evolving. So it is a philosophical approach which helps us in developing new ideas. In this context, Andrew Hecker says that every political theorist is part philosopher and part scientist. Now let us study the criticism that has been leveled against the philosophical approach. As all of you know that every other idea and every other concept in political science has its own significance and it attracts its own criticism. Philosophical approach is no exception to this. So even philosophical approach attracts criticism. It is said that the philosophical approach has led to the decline of political theory. The philosophical approach, as we all know, is largely speculative, and since it dwells in the realm of ideas and values, it is said that the philosophical approach has neglected what is. It has neglected the facts, it has neglected the empiricism, and because of this, the political theory has been reduced and its scope has been compromised. It is also said that the philosophical approach is speculative, and since it is speculative, it is non-scientific, it ignores the reality, it ignores the objective facts, and because of this, the conclusions and the inferences that we draw out of the philosophical approach are debatable. Like for example, Plato says that it is the philosopher king who should rule the state. Now this statement attracts criticism, as some other theorist may say that what if the philosophical king turns dictator? So you see, the results of the philosophical approach are debatable. It is also said that the philosophical approach neglects empiricism. It neglects what is real, as we've discussed so far. And so this has caused the decline of the political theory. Some political theorists also say that the philosophical approach has led to the death of political theory. Aristotle also happens to be somewhat critique of the philosophical approach. If Plato says that the king ought to be wise in the world of ideas, Plato says that the king must be worldly wise. The king should be wise in the practical world. He should have practical wisdom. In this context, Leo Strauss, who is a post-behavioral scholar, says that the political philosophy and political science are coterminous. So it is not that the philosophical approach is irrelevant in the present times, and political philosophy as well as the political science are equally important, and together they make political theory a lot more profound and robust. Now let us summarize what we've studied so far and how you should understand and study this topic of philosophical approach. You should note that what is philosophical approach, what is the significance of this approach, what are the limitations of this approach, what is the criticism leveled against it, what are the strengths and weaknesses of this approach, and so on. So whenever you write an answer on this topic, try to include all these points in your answers. It will make your answers very comprehensive and it will give a sort of multi-dimensionality to your answers. This will certainly help you to fetch those extra bounty points. So hope you've enjoyed this video. Thank you so much. You can also visit our website www.politicalscienceforum.in. Here you'll find a detailed write-up on this topic. So hope you've enjoyed the video. Thank you so much.